Hi everyone, my name is Timur and my team and I would like to rebuild Horten 229 aircraft. The Horten 9 or Horten 229, which is sometimes wrongly designated as Godhead 229, was a late World War II prototype fighter designed by Reinmar and Walter Horten and built by Godhead Wagon Fabric. This was the first production worthy form of an aircraft categorized as true flying wing, that is, an aircraft not relying on any sort of vertical tail surfaces to achieve flights and maneuverability. Additionally, it was the first pure flying wing powered by jet engines and designed to be much more difficult to detect with radar, the first aircraft to incorporate what is now known as stealth technology and the heavy use of swept back wings before they became the standard of the jet age. This aircraft was a personal favorite of German Luftwaffe chief Hermann Göring and was the only aircraft to come close to meeting his 3,000 performance requirement. Its speed was estimated at 1,000 km per hour, which is approximately 636 miles per hour, and its ceiling was estimated at 15,000 meters, which is about 50,000 feet. Horten 229 was a truly a marvel attempt in every way imaginable, and many prototypes were constructed to streamline its design. Successful test flights of the Horten version 1 led to the construction of the first powered wing, the Horten V2, but poor communications with the engine manufacturers led to the lengthy delay in finishing this aircraft. After a few hours of very successful flights, where Horten outperformed Messerschmitt 262 jet airplane, it suffered from a serious engine malfunction and crash-landed, which destroyed this prototype. Nevertheless, an updated prototype Horten V3 was placed into the production by 1945, but this machine never contributed to the German war effort in any respect, thus leaving the reader's imaginations as to the impact the system would have had in the skies over Europe. During the final stages of the war, the US military found Horten 229 prototypes version 3 through version 6 at Friedrich Schroeder, Germany, and at least 5 other Horten airframes were recovered at the Godhead Wagon Fabric plant. Most airframes were destroyed, fearing that they might fall into the arms of the Red Army, while single Horten version 3, which was undergoing final assembly along with a Horten glider, were sent to the Northrop Corporation in the United States for research and evaluation. At this point, not much is left of legacy of this aircraft except a few airframes stored in restricted facilities and a handful of black and white pictures scattered over the internet. This is where our team comes in. We have a full set of Horten 229 version 3 production blueprints from Deutsche Museum, 5,000 square foot production facility in Long Island, which will be used to manufacture main airframe components, staff with metal work experience that can execute virtually any type of project for automotive or airspace needs, industrial tools, professor from Moscow Aviation Institute to guide us in the right directions, CAD designer, project administrator, and a burning desire to rebuild this aircraft. In addition, we are also planning to secure space at Farmingdale Airport in Long Island, which will be used for the final assembly and testing of this aircraft. We are also planning to hire an additional 6 airframe and power plant mechanics in order to finish this project as planned. The aircraft will be manufactured from the modern materials, a combination of aluminum alloys and vacuum-molded carbon fiber-reinforced polymer, and upon completion we are planning to certify it under experimental category. This aircraft will be powered by 2 General Electric CJ610 jet engines, which are non-afterburning turbojet engine derived from military J85s. Once certified, we will perform a numerous flight test in order to check aircraft's performance and handling capabilities. Parallel to the manufacturing and testing processes, we are also planning to create a documentary film on production and flight tests. Upon final completion, this aircraft will be sold, and all resources obtained will be used to fund another equally exciting World War II aircraft project. To learn more about our team and Horten 229 project, please visit our webpage located at hortenwings.com.
Headquarters, Freeman Field, Air Tactical Service Command, Seymour, Indiana, 30th of January, 1946. To Commanding General, Air Tactical Service Command, Wright Field, Dayton, Ohio. The Horten 9 jet-propelled flying wing is not being considered for restoration to flight condition. A portion of the center section and one incomplete wing panel are available at Freeman Field. The other wing panel is not available. During a visit of Colonel Chalik to Freeman Field on 25th of January, a visual inspection of the Horten 9 was conducted. There was complete concurrence in the fact that reconstruction is not feasible and is impossible without a redesign of the basic aircraft. Signed, Colonel H.C. Dorney.